Hey everyone, welcome back. In this video, we are going to continue where we left last time and make the intermediate version. I'm going to create a new Python file, call this one as intermediate.py. And for now, I'm going to copy everything that is in the main into the intermediate.py file. The basic workflow has only a positive prop and an output image. This time, we are going to add an input image plus a slider to control the influence of that image. I'm going to remove the last two lines, and I will also change the interface name to intermediate. Now we have the positive prompt, so let's just make this as a new line, and just below the text box, I would want to have image, and I'm going to label this as, let's create something about the style. So let's do style image. Also want to have a slider to control the influence, and the slider has a minimum and a maximum parameter. So minimum, I'm going to go with 0.0, and then maximum, I will do 1.0. There's also steps, I will do 0.05. I'll save this. In the process function, we'll need to capture these inputs. So we are going to have an image as well as a slider. So let's go back to ComfyUI. I will be adding an IP adapter. And just to do a quick test, I guess we can try with this and just change the prompt from woman to man and see what we get. All right, so now we know that the image is working. Now we need to save this workflow now, and I'm going to save it as intermediateworkflow.json. Again, copy the workflow and put it in your project directory. Now we need to identify the node or the input image. So that is number 15, and then the IP adapter is number 14, or the weight. Let's go all the way down. Number 14, we'll need to go to 14 inputs weight. And then for 15, we'll do number 15 inputs and then image here. Now you can see this image has a name here. And this name is basically the name of the image that we pass in. Now the way ComfyUI works is that when we upload an image here, when we click on choose file to upload and we select an image, it's going to upload the image and save a copy of the image in ComfyUI. And if we go into inputs, we are going to see the input here. So we can see character face. If I show the picture, you can see it's the exact same thing. So what we're going to do is we can change this name to intermediate, and let's just say style image. I'm going to copy it. Now we have to do the saving ourselves. Now, first, make sure that in your settings, you have this line, ComfyUI path, and it is pointing to the correct ComfyUI folder. Let's go back into intermediate.py, and we'll say from settings, import ComfyUI path. Now, just to separate things, I'm going to create a new function, save underscore input underscore image, and this save underscore input underscore image is going to get the image as its parameter. Now, images that we upload using the Gradio application, so when we do this gr.image, we get the image inside the process function, which we are going to pass to this save input image.
In terms of image format, ComfyUI works with tensors, whereas Gradio works with NumPy array. So we'll need to do a little bit of conversion when we are working with the images. For our application, we are going to convert from a NumPy array to a pillow object, and then use that pillow object to save it inside the correct directory.
First, let's give it the name input folder for ComfyUI, and to make it easier to work with folder path or file path, we'll go at the top. I will do from path lib import path with a capital P, and then I'm going to create a path object, and I will pass this ComfyUI path to it. Now this alone is not pointing towards the input folder, but the path object gives us a quick shorthand to concatenate path. So I can put a forward slash and then input folder. So just to illustrate, let's go back into ComfyUI. So this is my file explorer, and this ComfyUI path that we have, it's pointing towards this folder. So if I go in, inside this folder, there's another folder called input, Inside the folder, we have the character face or whatever example.png image that we have, right? So, and that is why I'm joining it here. Now, let me change this name. Actually, let's just do input image. We'll do everything in one go. And we have this folder input. We need to save it using the same name as inside the node here. So whatever name you have in your workflow, you need to use this exact name. I'm going to copy the name, go into intermediate, and then paste it at the end. So my full path is going to be ComfyUI folder, input folder, and then intermediate style underscore image dot jpeg image. This is going to be the path. Now next, we'll just convert the image. Let's import pillow first. So from PIL, import image. And because we have image here, image, it's going to be a little bit confusing to just say image every time. So I'm going to change the parameter to img and then change this to img as well. All right, so image is the object from the pillow library. So we are going to say image dot from array, and then we'll pass img to it. This is going to give us a pillow image. Now with this pillow image, there is a nice method basically called save, and we can pass in a path to it. So the path is input img. Now this function is responsible to save the input image that the user will upload inside ComfyUI in the correct directory. Now let's use it. Once we've opened the workflow, we have the positive, pretty much the same. Before we make the request and we send the prompt, we are going to save the image, img, here. Now let's also implement the slider, and we can actually do this here. We'll say prompt, and let's check the intermediate workflow. It's the ID 14 inputs wait. Let me just copy this line. The ID is 14 inputs, and then we have wait here, and this is going to be the value that we'll get from the slider here. So far the only thing that we've done is added these two lines here. Make sure that we are capturing inside our process function, saving the image in the correct directory, and then using the slider value. Okay, so now we need to connect this intermediate interface, this here. We need to connect it with our main interface. Otherwise, we are going to get two applications. We'll get one basic application and then an intermediate application. But I want to have everything in one application. So to do this, we'll need to modify the interface. Now, Gradio has something that's called a tab interface. Basically, it's going to provide a tab system similar to your tab inside of a browser, multiple tabs, right? Now, this tab interface, it takes in interfaces as a list. So there is interface list, and then we have a list, and then we also have tab names, which is another list. So let me change this name to basic, and inside my interface list, I will pass basic. I will also pass intermediate here, which is the intermediate interface. So we need to import intermediate in our main.py. Let's go to the top. I'm going to do it here. We'll say from intermediate, import intermediate. The naming is a little bit funny, but I hope it's not too confusing. Now, if you do not pass anything in the tab name, if you remove it, this basic interface will change the name to tab one. This one will get tab two. Just to make it easier, we are going to say basic workflow. And then for the second one, we are going to say intermediate workflow, right? So this is going to be the tab interface. Now I'm going to change and assign the name demo to this. And then everything else is the same. We are still going to do the queue and launching it. But instead of launching the gradio.interface directly, we are launching the tab interface. So now let's run main.py. Now it's very important to run main.py and not intermediate.py. All right, so once you see running on local URL, go back to your Gradio application and you will need to refresh. Okay, so now you see that at the top we have basic workflow. This is a tab. And then we have intermediate workflow, another tab. So I can switch between the basic and intermediate workflow. For the intermediate workflow, we have a positive prompt, we have a style image, and then we have a slider which do not have a name. Let's go back into intermediate, and that is correct. I did not add a label to the slider. So I'm going to add label and I will say image weight. Okay, restart the application and refresh the page. And now we have a slider for image weight. Let me just put it at 50%. And I've just uploaded an image here. I'm using this image just to show you that we are taking this image into consideration when generating the image. So ComfyUI is taking this one. Let me just say a cute Pokemon-like object. I just say monster. Not sure if we are going to get something similar to this. Let's increase the weight to 0.7 and let's submit. Okay, so we got an error and right now it's telling us that we do not have the ID 14 and I know why. Let's go to intermediate and if you remember correctly, I copied the main.py and pasted it inside of intermediate, but I forgot to change the workflow. Right, so this workflow, it's not called basic, but instead it's called intermediate_workflow.json. So make sure you're updating your workflow and using the correct name here. I'm going to restart and click on submit. Now it's processing and I go back into ComfyUI input. You will see I have a new file here and it is the exact file that I uploaded into my application. And there we go. So now we have this creature here that's using this image as a reference. Now, of course, now you can make improvements. If your user is using this application from their smartphone, they will automatically get a camera icon here. Gradio will handle that for you. And they can use their smartphone camera to take a picture and it will get uploaded here. However, one thing to note there is that smartphone cameras can take high resolution pictures, so the images can be in 4K or 8K in some cases. So you may want to do a little bit of image processing before you upload this image into the ComfyUI input folder.
All right, so that was it for the intermediate version. Next time we are going to work on an advanced version where we are going to remove the positive prompt completely and then replace it with checkboxes, drop-down menus, and radio buttons. I will also explain how you can programmatically inside your code connect and disconnect nodes. So that was it. Thank you for watching until the very end. I will see you in the next one.